We were having a conversation.
I want to understand.
I'm diverted.
Listen.
You've divided it somewhere else.
What is your name?
Perhaps.
What is your name?
You can call me Missionary. That's my Discord name.
No, what is your name?
I am
that your mum and dad gave you.
My real name.
Right.
Go by
so you
my
see,
Discord name.
You are not.
Discord name
listen.
Is Missionary.
Listen. You are not willing to give your real name.
I don't
and
have
you,
to. I'm not obliged to.
You're not.
I'm giving you my name. My name I got for you is Missionary.
I agree.
Do you accept?
I agree. You're not obliged to give your name.
Fair enough.
So why do you consider that I'm obliged to give you the answer that you want?
Because one's personal, one's not.
It's personal
my
to me.
My name's personal to me.
Personal
it's
to you.
It's attached to me. It's what represents me.
So your name is such a name that you can't even tell
why
other people.
Why are we still diverting? We were
right.
on a subject.
Forget your name. Forget
brother,
your name.
And you've diverted me
okay.
away. Then I've come to
let's
you
come to that.
On the same subject,
let's,
asking whether or not
let's come to this.
Saki al-Bukhari
I do.
And Saki al-Muslim.
I do.
So you are a Sunni.
Really?
I said, are you? I said, so you are.
So hang on. So if I accept Sahih Bukhari and
yes,
Sahih Muslim,
yes.
And I reject saying Muwatta of Imam Malik.
Right.
Does that make me a Sunni?
Are you a Sunni?
I'm asking you.
Brother, why question for question?
Because you want to know I accept Bukhari and Muslim or not.
Yes.
I am going to ask you now further.
Fair enough.
What if I reject Sunan ad-Darimi? Does it make
we
me a Sunni?
On a subject.
So do you know
and
what Sunan ad-Darimi is?
If you accept the hadith, so I know how to approach this
so
answer to you.
The reason why I'm trying to explain to him the way I'm
no,
doing
you're trying
is
to
you're interrupting. And let me
okay,
help
I
you.
I just noticed that camera's on there. Can I get Siri,
listen.
Soko or DCCI
listen.
Ministries cameras?
Why?
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 Because I've seen your channels and I know you snip out different bits.
Which is my channel?
And then give it some label.
Which channels?
I'm not saying
about?
Your channel in particular.
Which
I'm
is my channel?
I said you guys. Am
which
I
guys? Okay.
Particular?
Do you know which channels they are? Do you know which channels these are? Do you know what channels these are? Do you know what they are?
What do you mean?
Do you know how many cameras are recorded?
Yes, 1, 2,
what
three,
is
4, 5. How many
sure.
Christians here? Put your hand up if you're a Christian.
Listen, what is the likelihood?
How many Christians here?
What is the likelihood?
One Christian.
Of,
have you got a camera on you?
Are you listening?
No. No Christian cameras.
Missionary.
Yes.
What is the likelihood
yes.
that if one of the channels were to edit this
yes.
footage,
yes.
the others,
brother,
by looking at the others,
brother,
you can find out?
We may continue this discussion if we stick onto the topic and if there was a Christian camera here.
Listen. Firstly, are you willing to engage with the topic upon knowledge or upon ignorance?
I want to get on to this topic. I was having this
but,
brother, but the new
but I want to ask
a
you
question.
A simple question.
I
do
have
you want
a
to,
simple question you can answer it.
It's not I couldn't. I haven't.
You haven't.
And I,
so if you have the ability of doing
listen,
it, can you do it?
The ability is linked with knowledge. Do you agree?
Yes.
Right. So do you want to engage in a discussion
about... Now you're going to try and
listen,
put me into your little box. You're going to try and box me
missionary,
into
missionary.
This, the what is it? The standard of what you want me to
missionary?
Do. Yes.
Do you want to engage in a discussion upon
yes.
knowledge or upon ignorance?
Upon what I'm talking about.
No, upon knowledge...
Found,
no.
Do dawah. You're
do
not
you
answering
want to,
my question.
Do you want
do
to engage in a discussion...
Yes.
...upon knowledge or upon ignorance?
I would love to engage in a conversation and a discussion if
no,
there
that's
were
not the question.
Christian cameras.
Is it difficult for you to understand what I'm asking?
Well, it's clearly difficult when I
so,
ask you a question that you couldn't answer.
No, it's not I couldn't answer.
Then are you going
I
to answer
I haven't answered.
Then are you going to answer?
No.
Why
me,
should I answer your question?
Me answering
question?
A question depends on whether the discussion is
so you're
happening.
So you not going to answer my question?
I'm about to tell you.
You're about to tell me if you
yes.
can answer my question.
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
So the, yes, you are.
So the discussion...
Can I ask you again?
The discussion would
are you
be...
trying to take control of this conversation?
No.
Because I was having a conversation when I went somewhere.
Listen.
Yes.
Do you agree?
Nice to meet you, Chef. I saw your videos.
Do you agree?
Yes.
Any discussion upon knowledge is beneficial,
yes.
upon ignorance it's not.
Depends what you mean.
Okay, what's this so difficult about
if
my question?
If two ignorant people had a conversation...
Yeah. Are you ignorant or knowledgeable?
Depends. In what? That's
on the subject.
That's a general question.
On this subject.
On this subject?
Yeah.
Do you even know what the subject is?
I'm asking you, do you
if you
know?
Came into this conversation...
Okay.
Whatever subject.
What is
whatever subject? We're having a conversation
listen,
and
listen,
you
listen,
jumped in.
Listen. He is saying
yes.
This subject that
yes.
we came to discuss.
Yes.
We have knowledge about it or not? Whatever subject that
well,
we
I'm not ignorant of it.
I'm asking you.
I looked at the tafsir, I've got the tafsir of the surah, so yes, I'm not ignorant.
So
I did my research.
So you claim
yes.
that you have knowledge about the subject that we came to discuss.
Yeah? Knowledge is in. A bit of background history,
in the
context around the surah.
In
yes.
the subject. Now here he is saying to you, he
yes.
wanted to tell you.
Yes.
That in Islam, if you know
right.
things in Islam, there is nothing in Islam without fundamentals. Nothing in Islam, anything in Islam without fundamentals. We have, for example, if you want to become Muslim, there is a fundamental of Islam to go through it. Yeah.
Right.
Similarly, if you came to ask about, for example, Sahih Bukhari, right. Before you came to Sahih Bukhari, you said there are fundamental
backgrounds. Yes, which is why I asked you whether or not you're a Sunni or Shia. They wanted to know whether or not.
One second. I'm trying to help you out here with this. So he is asking you a simple question. Same
I asked him a simple question.
One second. When you asked that question, you said, do you believe in Sahih Bukhari or not? He is saying, he is directing you to the fundamental. He's saying to you, before we come to
in other words, diverting me away.
No. That's wrong. But this is wrong.
Why is it wrong?
I will tell you why. Because he is not diverting. He's saying to you, we will come to Sahih Bukhari. Definitely. He said before.
My question is about Sahih Muslim. I want to
listen. Right, listen. You have 2 ears and 1 mouth. Do you know why?
Is that
you have 2 ears and 1 mouth.
Is that an insult?
No. I'm asking you. Means for all of us.
Is that an insult? All of us.
No, all of us.
All of us.
You have 2 ears and 1 mouth.
Not just me in particular.
No. I have 2 ears and 1 mouth.
Right. Yeah.
Meaning we need to listen more than we talk. Yeah.
Right.
He is saying to you, before we get to this point, let's talk about the fundamentals, and then in the conversation we'll come to Sahih Bukhari.
Is the Dawah speech?
No, generally.
I've seen this before.
You said you claimed initially that you have knowledge.
I have knowledge, yes.
Okay, good.
Right.
So if you have knowledge,
I have knowledge is that I know the tafsir of the surah. Right. I know the context.
Okay. That means if you know the tafsir of the surah, that means you don't have knowledge.
I don't have knowledge.
Yeah, you have knowledge about that surah only, but you don't have knowledge about the
Quran. I've read the Quran.
Yeah. No problem. Anyone read the Quran. The issue is, if you wanted to come through Islam, you want to discuss anything in Islam, before we get to anything, we have to start from the fundamentals.
So may I ask you a question? Why did you both interrupt you with one of the brothers?
I'm here, I'm not debating you.
So you're not debating me?
I'm just making kind of facilitating this debate. Clarifying this. So his question was saying, before you come to Sahih Bukhari, he has no problem to answer.
Sahih Muslim, I'm not going to Sahih Bukhari. He is pointing you
to start with the fundamentals.
Why should we start with the fundamentals?
Because otherwise, everyone will get lost. Because you could say, okay, one second, I will ask you.
So you can't directly answer my question then?
Suppose I believe in Sahih Bukhari, for example. Do you know, if you know about Sahih Bukhari, do you know what are the conditions of Sahih Bukhari?
What?
Do you know
I'm not going to Sahih Bukhari.
But you said you come, you ask the
I
question.
I want to know whether or not you're a Sunni or Shia Hadith, so we know how to approach the question to you.
Okay, we are Sunni.
You are Sunni. Why didn't you just answer
We are Sunnis now, and we are saying to you.
Now you are, so you weren't before.
We were.
You said you're Sunnis now, weren't you before? Clearly you weren't when you said that you weren't going to answer the question.
I mean, you said you watched me, yeah?
Second, sorry?
You said you watched me.
I've watched you before, yeah.
And you watched him.
I watched the debate with Pastor David Lynn. You accepted that Jesus Christ was our Lord and Saviour. Hallelujah!
Okay, you watched me?
Yes.
And you watched him?
Have I watched him? Yes, I have.
And you don't know that you are Sunni?
Second, sorry?
And you don't know that you are Sunni?
I don't know you're Sunni. I've never heard the admission that whether or not you are Sunni.
You never watched that.
What?
That you never watched that.
Depending on the video. I haven't watched every single video of yours.
Okay. Now,
maybe the video you said you were Sunni, I didn't watch.
Okay. For you to understand, before you came to shout, by the way, and I haven't come to shout.
I've come here to speak about this with one of the brothers until you came over to me and diverted
from here. You cannot go. I will say to you, I will repeat.
Black fire!
This provocation is intentional, isn't it?
Yeah.
They want to create a scene so that they can do something in the speaker's corner. This corner where lots of fruitcakes coming over. And what we mean by fruitcakes are people who are not sincerely interested in having a discussion which are meaningful and beneficial, exchange of ideas and knowledge from between each other. But rather they come here with a totally brainwashed mind without the ability to differentiate between, you know, an intelligent discussion and otherwise. And also, what's happening recently, as you can see, this is deliberately inciting, you know, hot-headed people to create some kind of scene like this, and somehow they want to then label certain groups or groups of people are very extremist and so on. So unfortunately, people need to realize that this is not an isolated case, it's part of a bigger scheme. And this is a part which is under the influence of a bigger scheme. So may Allah give us the ability to understand this. Okay.